Good morning, student. In this lecture, we will discuss about the non-mulberry sericulture. So, non-mulberry sericulture is pesticized by tussar silk, eerie silkworm, and muga silkworm. Tussar silkworm is also known as the it is Lepidoptera, and it is known as the Anthidia papia. So moths are fairly large insects and female being large and yellowish brown in color, while male smaller, brick red in color, and eyes are prominent spots on with their having prominent spots on their wings. Eggs are laid on tender leaves of host tree, and moth lays about 200 eggs. So the egg stage 8 to 10 days, and caterpillars are stout green with red sparkle, and larva period is 40 to 5 days. So cocoon are oval, large as hen's egg, and hard from the terminal branches by the stiff attachment about 5 cm long. Pupal stage lasts 15 to 13 days. So most do not mate in captivity, and so the caterpillars cannot be domesticated. As such, the cocoons have to be collected from the host trees in the forest. So tussar moths are bivoltine, giving 2 crops a year, and during August to October, and others during October to December. So tussar silk is reliable, therefore the pupa have to be killed before emergence of is reliable, so that pupa have to be killed before emergence of the moth to prevent cutting of the silk thread into pieces. So other non-mulberry silk is eerie silkworm. Eerie silkworm, also known as the Samia cynthia resni. So Lepidopterans, their moths have brown, black or green colored wings with white crescent marking and woolly white abdomen. Female lays about 300 to 500 eggs, and hatching time is 7 to 10 days. And caterpillar feed on castor leaves and can pupate anywhere. So no chandraki is required. So cocoon are not compact but loosely spun, and silk is white or brick red in color. Since the thread is not a continuous one, the moth can be allowed to emerge from cocoons, and after emergence the cocoons are reversed to remove the pupal case. So the cocoons are then soaked in cold water for 18 hours, warm water for 45 minutes, washed in washing soda solution, and about 28 gram of egg will give 1600 larva, which can yield 4 kg of silk after consuming leaves about 0.5 hectare of castor crops. So eerie silkworms are rearing on the castor crops. Then is the muga silkworm, also non mulberry silkworm. So muga silkworm, that is Anthidia asamensis helfner, this is Lepidopterans, resemble tussar silkworm. Lot many similarity with the tussar. The wings and body of female moths are copper brown to dark brown. Female moth lays 400 to 500 eggs. Hatching time is 7 to 16 days. Larva stage is 28 to 38. And muga silkworms are polyphagous, semi-domesticated and multi-volatile, having 5 to 6 overlapping generations in a year. And the mate is then kept above an oven where hot air and smoke kill, and degumming is done by boiling the cocoons in alkaline solution of sodium carbonate and for 10 to 30 minutes, after which the cocoons are reeling. So these are the muga silkworm, eerie silkworm, and then is the tussar silkworm. These three are known under the non-mulberry sericulture practices.